Here I want to discuss series reactions in chemical reactors and then how we would maximize selectivity. So we have more than one reaction taking place in almost all chemical reactors. And so often more important than rate would be selectivity. And a common way of defining selectivity is the rate of formation of a desired product over the rate of formation of all the products. So in a series reaction, then, so series A reacting to B, B subsequently reacting to C, and this is generic reaction. For example, if we were to look at hydrogenation or oxidation reactions, certainly a common type where I have reactant, say, reacting with oxygen to make some product, and this can react with additional oxygen to make some other product. This might be CO2. This might be a partially oxidized organic, and we certainly want to make the partially oxidized organic instead of CO2. So it turns out then for series reactions that reaction time is our most important variable. Certainly temperature is going to change the relative rates of formation of B and C, and higher temperature will favor the reaction with the higher activation energy, as discussed for parallel reactions in another screencast. But if we just concentrate on the effects of reaction time, because that's what we can control, so as the concentration of A decreases, then the concentration of B, our desired product, increases. But as the B concentration increases, then the rate that B goes to C increases, because typically the rate is proportional to the concentration of B. And so that means picking the right type reactor or the right type reaction time will give us high selectivity. If we run for this amount of reaction time, we don't convert all of our reactant, but we'll have high selectivity. If we run for much longer time, we'd have much lower selectivity. So I'm looking at concentrations here. And of course, concentrations in a plug flow reactor are going to be proportional to flow rates at a given location. And so the selectivity at the intermediate time, the selectivity here would be something like, I have the product B, looks like it's about 2/3 of the total of B plus C. So selectivity here is around, say, 0.7 at the longer time. So this is the short time. The selectivity out here at the longer time, very small amount of B, maybe it's 0.05. So rather dramatic difference with time. If we want to maximize selectivity for a series reaction, then we have to control the reaction time.